The central goal of any quantum computing efforts is to achieve reliable, accurate computation. The main obstacle, however, is noise, which can lead to uncontrollable effects on the information stored and manipulated by a quantum computing device. Here, we give a brief overview of the strategies one can employ to reduce the effects of noise in quantum computers. The strategies are such that, as we go down the list, we have increased power to remove the negative effects of noise, but at increased cost in terms of the complexity of implementation. And here I mean complexity in the English sense of the word. We begin with the most fundamental approach, that of low-noise hardware design. Here, I mean a careful choice of quantum physical components with good, meaning low-noise, properties. This can be about choosing the physical qubit, the basic information carrying system, in a wise manner. For example, we can choose a pair of atomic levels that interact only very weakly with the environment. This can also be about using experimental techniques to shield and isolate the chosen qubits from noise, and so on. Low-noise hardware design is absolutely crucial. Without it, none of the strategies below will work well at all. Next, we have passive noise reduction. Passive here describes strategies that are about pre- or post-processing of the quantum information to reduce the negative effects of noise. This is in contrast to active noise cancellation as the computation proceeds. Under passive noise reduction, we have two broad categories. The first is decoherence-free subspaces or noiseless subsystems. This can be thought of as pre-processing information in that one chooses to put the quantum information in a particular subspace or subsystem of the full physical Hilbert space. This subspace or subsystem has the special property that the noise acts approximately as the identity operation there. If this is the case, any information stored there will suffer only minimal effects from the noise. Such a subspace or subsystem exists, of course, only if there is some symmetry in the noise that supports a non-trivial subspace or subsystem. This strategy may hence simply not be available for a given situation. The second category of passive noise reduction strategies is what I will refer to as software error mitigation. This includes a broad range of strategies, largely motivated by the recent drive for implementing quantum algorithms on NISQ-era devices with low-resource demand error mitigation techniques. They can involve careful design of the quantum algorithm, for example, to minimize the circuit depth or the number of particularly noisy gate operations, or repeating the algorithmic circuits with different noise strengths or different observables, and then post-processing the gathered data to guess the computational answer as if there was no noise. We come then to the last group of strategies, that of active noise removal. Here, the active refers to additional operations performed during the quantum computation itself to remove the effects of noise on the quantum information processing. Again, there are two categories. The first is dynamical decoupling and its variants. Here, we are talking about applying fast gates, fast compared to the variational time scale of the noise, to actively cancel out the noise. This usually involves applying some particular gate sequence, chosen such that the gates have the overall effect of averaging away the noise at the completion of the sequence. The limitation of such schemes is that the cancellation is good really only for noise that evolves slowly compared to the total sequence time. The second category of active noise removal strategies is quantum error correction. Quantum error correction is a general method that can deal with any residual noise left over after all the above strategies have been implemented. It involves putting the quantum information into a special part of the quantum state space, special in that some class of noise, usually the dominant remnant noise in the system, can actually be detected and then corrected. This removes the effects of the noise, at least up to some particular noise strength, but it does come at the cost of many more gates, many more qubits, etc. Most of these strategies are reliant on particular hardware and or of algorithmic properties. In the remainder of the lecture, we will focus on quantum error correction, the general approach towards large-scale, accurate quantum computers.